I-90 east of Kittitas, near the old Milwaukee Railroad trestle. The freeway rolls through Johnson Canyon here, but look carefully at milepost 119. It's going to go by quick. A brilliant white layer just above the creek bed. What is it? There are plenty of white layers this side of Snoqualmie Pass. Is it diatomite, a lake bed deposit made of microscopic hard-shelled algae? How about caliche, a hardpan mineral deposit below soil level? Or maybe a volcanic mudflow like we saw back at Thorpe. Nope. This is volcanic ash, blown downwind from the Cascades. This is not just any ash. This is the famous Mazama ash from southern Oregon. A Mount Rainier-like volcano, Mount Mazama, blew itself up 7,700 years ago and left Crater Lake National Park. That's 300 miles from here. Ash from the mountain spread over the Pacific Northwest. 43 times more ash than the Mt. St. Helens blanket in 1980. In this creek bed, the Mazama ash is 4 inches thick, and the 1980 St. Helens ash is less than 1/4 inch of ash. Think how much trouble we had in 1980 with 1/4 inch. How did the local Native Americans deal with 4 inches? The Mazama ash is king out here. No other ash bed rivals its regional thickness. A useful time marker used across the Pacific Northwest. There's even Mazama ash in seafloor cores off the coast of Washington. The Columbia River hauled the ash out there. On the seabed, sitting above the Mazama ash, are 13 sandy deposits that were created by 13 tsunami-triggering magnitude 9 earthquakes that struck repeatedly over the last 7,700 years. Here at Johnson Canyon, the Mazama has quiet deposits on top of it. This is loose, wind-blown silt sitting on top of the Mazama. But a newly discovered fault that has broken the Mazama ash bed here means young magnitude 7 earthquakes have jolted eastern Washington since the Ice Age.